Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I have come up with one more logic building problem, that is calculating sum of non-prime index values. So you will be given an array with n elements and you are expected to find the sum of values that are present in non-prime indexes of the array. So for those who are not having idea what is a prime number, a quick explanation of prime number. Basically, a prime number is a natural number that is greater than 1 and has no positive divisors other than 1 and itself. So in simple, it is a whole number which is greater than 1 that has only two factors, 1 and itself. So you will be given two inputs in which one of the input is an array that contains elements and the second input is length of the array. And as said, we are supposed to find out the sum of numbers that are present at non-prime indexes within the array. I have picked up two of the test cases. Here you can see input 1 is having 10 elements with 92478985 63, and input 2 is the length which is representing 10. And coming to output, so you should return the sum as 36, and here in the brackets I have presented how you got that particular sum. Among 10 digits or indexing starts from 0 to 9, when the array is of length 10, indexing starts from 0 to 9, and the prime numbers up to 20 are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. So these are the prime numbers within 20. As said, who has only two factors, 1 and itself. Excluding these indexes, rest all indexed values you are going to sum, which you are going to get the value that is to be returned. And example 2, I have picked up 20 elements, and among those 20 elements, as mentioned just now, excluding these 8 indexes, rest of the index values if you sum it, you are going to get this value 80. Now let me quickly show you my code and run these both test cases and then explain how I have implemented that particular code. So this is my code. As said in previous videos also, you are not going to read these inputs. Directly you will be given in form of arguments and you just need to start writing from this line, and even this is not required. Here also I am reading the values, so this line you are going to write and then from here onwards you are going to continue. So before showing my code, let me run with both the test cases. So 10 size, and let me copy and paste it, and here I go. So you can see 36. Now let me show the second test case as well. So the second test case, I have taken 20 elements and same values I have repeated, and there you go, you are getting it 80. Now coming to the code, what I have written, so I and j for loops purpose I have taken, c is something like a flag variable, sum for calculating the sum, and this is only for my desktop application I am reading the inputs. And since indexing starts from 0 and index 0 and 1, they are non-prime numbers, that's the reason initialized sum with sum of input 1 of 0 and input 1 of 1, and input 1 is containing array of elements. So I have started from index 2 onwards, and running through the length of the array where input 2 is containing the length. And as said, C initialize it to 0 and then j equal to 2, j less than or equal to I by 2. That means if I check whether that particular number has a divisor within half of its size, obviously we can understand then it's not a prime. So accordingly we are checking it, and if this C is getting incremented means then it is a non-prime. If C is getting incremented means that is a non-prime. That's why here if C not equal to 0, then it is a non-prime index. So we are just adding the value at that particular index and storing it in sum, and we are performing this cumulative sum and finally returning that sum. Since I am displaying on my desktop, I am using this system.out.println. So you can just replace it with return statement. So this is my code for calculating the sum of non-prime index values, where you will be given two inputs, array containing values, and then the length of the array. So you just need to find the sum of non-prime index values. I hope everyone understood this particular code. I'll come up with one more logic building problem in my next video. And other logic building problem solutions, links are provided in the description box. You can just have a look at them. Thanks for watching.